makes you not want to take your shirt off. You don't know what I do. I beat the pussy. It's not tender. Hair puller. I was in Houston last night. That was scary. Look, I'm not knocking Dallas. I know you. I used to watch the show when I was a kid. The place is great. I saw some shit in the paper in Houston that was horrifying. All right, look. There was a serial rapist in Houston. Now, listen, ladies and gentlemen, understand, rape is never funny. The only reason I bring this particular rapist up is because all of his victims were men. Some crazy shit. 7 men in the Houston area came forward and reported this guy, which means he must have raped thousands. That is a very difficult phone call for a man to make. No hotline or support group for male rape. If a man gets raped in America, you just gotta get up and walk that shit off. Just think of it. Why is shit going on in this world? It's a scary world. Maybe that should be my message. Hopelessness. I thought about this. I was going to do a message of hope, but someone else took it. And hopelessness is just as important. You cannot be hopeful unless you're hopeless, ladies and gentlemen. And I'll give you an example, okay, how they exist together. Hope would be the child is born in Africa. Ladies and gentlemen, that is hope. And hopelessness, oh, this is awful. Hopelessness is that child is born without feet. You can fucking imagine something so horrible. Something that you take for granted. Your feet have always been there. This child was born with none. But hope comes back. Via this child's own determination and the love and support of his family and his community, he grows into a strong man. He overcomes the seemingly insurmountable obstacle of being born without feet. As a matter of fact, he's better than a strong man. He's an athlete. He's a runner. He's one of the fastest people to run. And he's never even had feet. Ladies and gentlemen, that is hope. And of course, hopelessness. That man is in jail tonight. I know you don't want to talk about it. Oscar Pretorius, or whatever, the South African runner. Foot the soldier, whoever it is. Foot the soldier. In a very tragic sequence of events, that man shot and killed his girlfriend for many years. Fucking awful. And really, that's it. There's no mystery. He definitely shot. Mystery is in the law. Did he intend to kill her? And he says he didn't. He says that he thought he was shooting someone else, a burglar. Not a good excuse in America, but in Africa, I can see that. No, burglary is really bad in South Africa. Rich South Africans are armed to the teeth. They protect their homes largely themselves. And, you know, someone breaks into the house, they very well could shoot and kill them. It's probably a lot like Texas. So, that's not necessarily good. No, that's not necessarily good. Or they got an argument and he got mad and he shot her. And if that's the case, ladies and gentlemen, then I'm at a loss because I cannot imagine what this woman could have possibly said to the guys. I didn't wrap my mind around it. But whatever she said, I'm pretty sure we could all agree, it's probably worse than not having feet. I see that dog and all that shit. This is a weird detail in the case that made me feel uncomfortable. Like, for instance, the one of the strangest little detail, apparently, at the time of the shooting, he didn't even have his feet on. all the way to another part of the house. That's maybe that's what started the allergy. Then she came home. She was tired, had a hard day. Didn't I tell you to put your feet in the closet and come home?
Didn't I tell you never to bring up my feet?
So I'll fuck you. Puts on a footloose rib and starts dancing around the house.
Footloose!
I couldn't even imagine.